I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at TangyLawTeam.com and let's get to work.
Well, Sheriff-elect Gerald Sticker is here at the Sheriff's Monthly Prayer Breakfast. Therein hangs a tale. That's right, Sheriff Daniel Edwards' outgoing administration is still doing these breakfasts, and I guess it's a fair bet to say that you'll continue the practice.
Absolutely. You know, we quite often we meet once a month here at the prayer breakfast and discuss it. And, you know, I was just asked even as of a few minutes ago, you know, and it's something that it's important to the community. It's important to our faith-based community. And ultimately, you know, we're going to try to build upon that and make it bigger, include more churches. And the prayer breakfast is definitely something that I will continue.
How can we utilize religion in law enforcement? Because I see so many examples of departments that do that to great effect.
Well, absolutely. You know, the Bible, I think, is Romans 13, maybe 4, whatever. But the Bible says that God's ordained the governing authorities and that they don't bear the sword for anything, that they do, you know, good by those that do good, and they, you know, the swords for those that do evil. So, you know, it's a biblical principle that God's ordained the governing authorities. And I think those of us in elected positions, if we realize that calling and we operate within those parameters, it will be to great success. And we all need to be pulling the same way. We were talking, had a conversation just a little bit earlier, and it was one of many about bringing a chaplaincy program into the sheriff's office, bringing a ministry into the jail. And so if we're educating those that are incarcerated, and if we ultimately, you know, because there again, the Bible says it's not against flesh and blood, but it's against powers and principalities that we're battling. So if we can, you know, affect that individual's character and moral compass, then, you know, they'll do right, and we'll do our part to help the faith-based community. And that's less people that we ultimately have to incorporate. Pie in the sky as it may be, we still have to strive for that.
Well, I'm a church and state separation guy, but if you look at the countries that have the best success in actually rehabilitating criminals, there has to be a right and wrong component. There just has to be.
Absolutely. You know, there, and that's, I think, you know, we can get down the rabbit hole discussing religion, but it's very, there's no more moral absolutes, you know, through over the last several centuries, you know, this was right and this was wrong, this was black and this is white. And now it's everybody has their own truth. You know, we, as more advanced have we become, we've actually become spiritually dumber. And so that's just my two cents on it.
Well, in the meantime, we could talk about this all day, and it would be an interesting topic, but there's more to say, including some personnel changes that you're ready to announce.
Sure. Look, we've, you know, we toured the jail. Sheriff Edwards has been more than accommodating through this transition as we're ramping up for that July 1 date. And here about 3 weeks ago, we toured the jail, and I brought my prospective warden in and have introduced him to Sheriff Edwards. And, you know, they're short-staffed as well in the jail. And so Sheriff Edwards said, this is your guy. He will be your guy. But he says, I'd welcome him in early to come in and just get acclimated, get the lay of the land, and start, you know, taking notes. And so, you know, that individual's Jerry Martin. He's a 20-plus year corrections professional from Orleans Parish Sheriff's Office. He was replaced when the new when Sheriff Sutton came in with the new administration. He lives here on the North Shore, and like I say, he's a wealth of knowledge, a wealth of experience, and he'll bring a fresh set of eyes. I have a local CPA out of Hammond, Randy Matthews of Taylor & Matthews accounting firm. She will be my chief financial officer for the sheriff's office. She has a lot of experience in governmental accounting, and she has a 20 plus years experience in the accounting realm. And it's a very important position. I said that when I was campaigning, that basically, you know, my number two guys, you know, is Chief Corkin, but that chief financial officer is going to be reporting directly to me as well. And so we have those positions. And so, and as of late here, just this past Saturday, I'm very excited to announce that we have John Riles. John's a retired major with Louisiana State Police. And he was a captain here at Troop L, which covers the Tangipahoa region. started at Southeastern Police Department years ago, 34 years ago, and is well respected in the law enforcement community. And just like Chief Corkin, he has a reputation of being no nonsense, by the book, and holding people accountable. And so it's just, we're on the right track, I feel, to start to change the culture of the sheriff's office, raise the bar on our men and women, hold them accountable, equip them and train them, but hold them accountable, and ultimately to do a better job for our citizens. That's the game plan.
Captain Riles has quite a reputation. He's supposed to be a real spit and polish, no nonsense kind of guy.
He is. The last day he got up, he polished his boots, you know, and he's been that way. I've known Major Riles, retired trooper, for 20 plus years. I've known him, worked alongside him, in the law enforcement community, and his reputation is impeccable, and his just a character, and his just level of work ethic, and he's just another godsend.
So he'll be number three in the department?
That's number three, yeah. Sorry, I went to public school here, so.
Yeah. What else are you working on? And I know you could give me an answer of probably 1,000 things.
Absolutely. We have an executive committee that we formed early on, and they're made up of, Tangipahoa professionals, business leaders. My executive team is Randy Matthews is on that. Jay Seal on the legal side. I have a couple of business minds, Mr. Mark Leto, who has Interparish Security, one of the biggest employers in Tangipahoa. And Mr. Stephen Guidry, who is owner of Great American RV here at Pumpkin Center Baptist, just solid business-minded people. Can't afford them because they're successful in their own right, but they're between Ms. Matthews and the rest of the team and the legal aspect, we're looking at the business of the sheriff's office. And we have subcommittees, the rebranding committee, where we will have new stripes on the cars, we will have a new badge, we will have a new uniform. It's just resetting the image for the department, rebranding it. And so we have a rebranding committee, we have a finance committee, we have another subcommittee that's looking at property that the sheriff's office controls or rents, and just that committee will going to be put eyes on every piece of property. What's its purpose? How much is it costing us? Are we duplicating efforts here? And just, we have to, money, like I've said it many times before, money drives everything. We need to find the money to pay those men and women that are doing the job if we're ever going to hope to retain them and have a professional sheriff's office.
You know, I think, and look, like you, I went to public school, but in hearing the arithmetic of Robbie Miller, our parish president, talking about the budget of parish government, which is now over $100 million, I think since he's been parish president, he has doubled the budget of Tangipahoa Parish. I stand to be corrected, but if my back of a napkin arithmetic is correct, and it's all federal grants. I mean, there's been luck as far as their sales tax receipts have been good, but it's mainly been the job he is doing in getting those federal funds. Maybe it's a pass-through with the state in some cases, but sure, you can work miracles if you do that stuff.
100%. President Miller and myself have had many conversations. The sheriff's office has a grant writer on staff, and just this week I'm learning that individual is leaving the department. And I think there's 4 to 6 grant writers that are employed by Tangipahoa Parish government. President Miller has offered those services to me. And so if that's a position that I don't have to fill, if I can, you know, piggyback off of, you know, President Miller and his grant writing team, then we have to fund the money somewhere. And I would love to bring that state and federal dollar, because we all pay taxes and we pay a lot of taxes, but let's pull some of that back into Tangipahoa Parish. I've met with several of our elected officials at the state and federal level. We were in DC here last month, and it was for the purpose of meeting, letting them know what we're doing in Tangipahoa Parish, our needs as far as the jail, our needs as far as law enforcement, just the lack of resources, and our state and federal partners, from our governor all the way up to the national level. You know, the door is open and conversations are taking place.
What else do you want to share with us?
Look, we're excited. July 1 can't get here soon enough, but we're busy. We're busy every day, meeting, And I just want, you know, just take a moment to thank Sheriff Edwards. His doors are wide open for us. Everything that we've asked for, whether it be employee roster or accounts payable, he has been more than accommodating. He's personally taking us on tours of his sheriff's office. And, you know, I'm very appreciative of that.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am Attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.